Powerlifting here in Druskininkai, Lithuania, and this session will be no exception.
Powerlifting is a sport composed by three main disciplines called lifts. They are, in order, squat, the bench press, and the deadlift. Each athlete has three attempts with 1 minute per attempt
to start the lift.
There are three referees, and each of them give a white light in case of a good lift and a red light in case of a no lift.
The athletes are separated per weight, age, and sex category. The sum of each of the best attempts per lift builds the total, and the athlete with the bigger total is the winner. In case of a draw, the lighter lifter wins.
The squat is the first movement of the competition. On that lift, the use of the legs and the back is extremely important. Once the athlete stands erect with his knees locked and the bar on his back, the central referee gives the squat command. The lifter then bends his knees and lowers his body until the top surface of the legs at the hip joint are lower than the top surface of his knees. He then comes back up, locking his knees and hips in order to complete the lift. The central referee will then give the rack command, and the athlete has to put the bar on the squat rack. There are three main mistakes to avoid in order to not have a no lift on the squat. First, if the athlete isn't standing erect with his knees locked at the beginning and at the end of the squat event. Second, if the proper competition depth isn't reached at the bottom of the movement. Third, if the athlete doesn't complete the lift with a single upward movement, meaning if the bar goes down during the ascent of the movement.
We are about to get underway with the squats here in Druskininkai, Lithuania. We have the 84 kilo class and the 120 plus A group for you today. The women will lift first and then we'll go straight into the men. My name's Joe Whiteley. I have here with me today Gary Williams.
Yeah, look, it has been an incredible week of lifting, and tonight this is going to be a fantastic session. You look at the under 84s, the nominations, it is so close on the nominations that there is nothing in it. And even their opening, if you look at some of the top runners, their opening lifts, their nominated opening lifts are so close as well. So we don't have the usual blowout that we often have.
Yeah, Rhea Stinn is the incoming world champion and she has a massive bench. She is the bench press world record holder. And looking at the projected totals, which is the openers added together, Rhea is on 625. Haranga is on 6.25 and Timmers is on 6.15. This could not be closer.
Yeah, there's nothing in it and there's not much between them in their nominated openers either.
We are going to start with Jane Aarberg, Denmark. She's going to open her squat with 210 kilos. Waiting in the wings for the referee to call bar loaded.
That's always tough to be the first one out.
And once bar loaded is called, she has 60 seconds to get the squat command from the centre referee. She doesn't have to complete the lift in that time. She just has to be set up to the satisfactory of all three referees.
So she squatted a 225 Europeans earlier this year. That should handle 210 without any problems. Well, it probably wasn't as clean as she'd like for an opener.
No, maybe just some nerves coming in there.
She got the job done, though.
Yeah, it was a good lift. It doesn't have to look pretty as long as it's performed within the rules. And next out is Sofia Kamlund, Sweden. Looking to open with 215.
again, competed at Europeans earlier this year with a 220. Was in Viborg last year, scored a 225.
She was just holding at the bottom there, trying to squeeze into depth. The
she was a long time down there too.
The if you see the lights on the bottom of the screen there, that we have three referees. They each give a vote whether they think it was a good lift for a white light or a no lift for a red light. And they give the little colour-coded failure as well underneath that red light. So the centre referee called it on depth, but the two sides were happy. 2-1 is good enough. Christy Civetta is already on the platform for 215, lifting for Great Britain. She's actually American.
She put in a massive squat at the Western Europeans this year, 230.
And that was a great looking opener. You don't want your opener to be too taxing. You still have a long way to go in the competition. Sits in really well there, keeps a back position really high. Great lift. Anki Timmers now, Netherlands. 220 on the bar.
Yeah, she put in a great performance at Europeans this year. Totaled 632 and a half.
Lifter with a very long history in the sport.
Looks like a good open up. Oh, not deep enough though.
So if we take a look at the replay,
certainly get a better angle here.
The hip must be below the top surface of the knee, and that just met parallel.
Yeah.
So you have to break parallel. It's not enough just to get there. So here's Reyestin, Canada, opening with 235.
Yeah, and you've got to talk about a long list of achievements.
You really do. She brought the gold medal home in the super heavyweight class from the World Games in Birmingham, Alabama last year. Three-time Open World Champion.
Yeah, she was the winner in Viborg, Stavanger, Dubai.
Three back-to-back world titles. Can she make it four? Some work to do on there.
Yeah, I think she did enough to get the job done, but it certainly wasn't one of her best looking squats.
Called on depth, but 2-1, it's a good lift. Now we have a 5-man jury here tonight. If it's a 2-1 decision, the jury can overturn. They have two monitors on their desk from different angles, and they get a slow motion replay as well. With a 5-man jury, it's a majority decision. If three of them want to overturn, then they will. Here's Anna Sørli Haranga, Norway, 260 on the bar. That's a tough one, yeah.
She put down in there all right, but just didn't really gather any speed out of the equipment at all.
The important thing is she's on the board. Here's Daria Rusinenko. She's opening the heaviest at 265, and she is a great lifter. Still in the juniors.
That's an impressive achievement, isn't it? To be here opening with the heaviest squat in the opens as a junior.
Bronze medalist last year in Viborg and in Stavanger the year before. Can she move up today?
Well, she's been sub-junior world champion.
Nice. Now the world record in this class is 2.76, so she's not far off that already. It's her own record she set in the Europeans in Denmark earlier this year.
It's a monstrous squat, isn't it?
So that's where we are after the first round of squats. Lysenko on 2.65, Aranga on 2.60, and Stin on 2.35. So here's Jane Aaberg for her second squat. She's gone up 7.5 to 217.5. Nice depth, but she's
struggling in the midsection there. She's going
to
stand it up though. She has got there, but that's going to make her third very tough.
So she needs to be thinking about conserving energy through to the last round of deadlifts.
And you were just talking about Rusenenko's world record, and I looked up on the board, she's put in 2.78 for her second lift.
And you know what, that's only 13, not
it's
even 13.
It's not even a big jump.
So I would not put that past her at all. But here's Anki Timmers to retry the 2.20. But she didn't quite get to depth last time.
Yeah, look, Anki's got plenty of experience. I mean, she would have come off of the last one, had a quick chat with the coaching team. This is what we need to do. You can see that squat suit is very tight, so it's going to be super hard to get through into depth.
So that suit is trying to resist all attempts to bend at the hips, and the knees are trying to stop you bending. The knee wraps are trying to stop you bending at the knees. And you have to press down through that equipment.
She gets 2-1 on that one and gets that one on the board.
So everyone has a squat in. Sophia Camland next. 2.22.5.
To get down into it. I think she got there.
Well, two of the referees think she did, so that is enough.
It's a long time at the bottom though, isn't it?
She's just having to press right through that suit. Christy Chivetta. Great Britain for 2.25.
Yeah, she had a great opener. It looked really good.
And that's another great squat.
Yeah, she has good technique. Where she really drives those hips through to stand up. And it's good use of the equipment too, because that's the direction the suit wants to take.
Here's Raistin. She's gone up a very modest 5 kilos. I think that's smart. Her opener didn't look super easy. She's done 2.57.5 before.
Yeah, look, and we talk about it all the time that you've got to lift for the day. I mean, it's all well and good that you might have done this in training a dozen times, but the day of competition is different.
So in a foreign country, the food's different. You may have changed body weights and your equipment doesn't fit quite the same, but that looked better than
her
first.
Yeah, that looked better than her first.
So that might give her and her coach confidence to take a slightly bigger jump. Really good line on that squat. And a Herringer, Norway, for 265. She took the silver medal in this class at Viborg last year. Now, I think she went a little deeper than she intended there.
She really sunk down, the hips popped up a little bit as well.
When you're in equipment, you have to be absolutely spot on or the equipment will punish you and push you offline.
Yeah, she just didn't lift the chest up as fast as she needed to. But she'll fix that on the next one for sure.
So already we have barely begun the session and we have a world record on the bar, 278 kilos.
Yeah, we're about 15 minutes in where we're going for a world record. So this will be a world open and junior record because she's still a junior.
So the only time you can take a half kilo, a chip as we call it, is when it is a world record. Usually you have to go up in increments of 2.5 kilos. Now she's a little bit late to the platform.
Yeah, I would have liked to have seen her out the platform a little bit earlier to not rush the setup on a lift like this, but here she comes.
Being coached today by her husband, took the silver medal a couple of days ago.
I'm going to wait for the referees on that one because I just feel she might have cut a little bit short,
but
no,
that was
she's
good.
In there deep enough.
That is a new world record for Daria Rusinenko on her second lift.
78, that is massive.
Now I'd expect her, whatever number she puts in next, I'd expect her to keep that chip, so maybe make it 283, something like that, and then that half kilo chip she can take all the way to the total means someone has to do 2.5 kilos more rather than just half. So Rusinenko in the lead right now as we move into the third round of squats.
Well, I just had a look on the board. Rusinenko is definitely keeping the chip at 288.
Do you think that's a step too far? Another 10 kilos?
That's a big step, isn't it?
It is. She's done two big squats and all using up your energy all the time. You're emptying the tank. Has she got another 10 kilos in her?
And it looks like Jane Aalborg is not coming out for her third squat.
So she's running the clock. If a lifter scratches and doesn't put an attempt in, that reduces the time for all the other people. And if you think you're three lifters out and you're suddenly two lifters out, you might have started to wrap your knees. Gary, would you start to wrap your knees?
Yeah, so depending on how fast the flight's moving, I mean, usually it's two to three lifters out, you start moving, but flights move faster than others. In this one here, it's moving really quick. So I'd be looking at three lifters out, maybe even before that lifter start the wrap process, so you're ready to go as soon as bar load is called.
And of course, you don't want to be standing in those tight knee wraps for longer than you have to.
Yeah, timing is everything with equipped lifting.
Anki Timmers now, Netherlands, for 225.
Yeah, I think the extra 5 kilos here is just right. I mean, I know she's got a lot more in the tank and she can do a lot more, but I think this is quite a smart move. Just going to put the 5 kilos on, make sure I'm not completely draining myself for the rest of this competition.
I'm going to wait for the referees here. I'm not certain whether that was deep enough. No.
No, and it wasn't. And she got one on the board, so that's the main thing. That means she could put a total in.
So again, like her opener, that just went to parallel and no further. But she's on the board. She got one squat.
That's right. So she can put a total in now. She needs to just put the bench on.
If you don't get a lift in one of the disciplines, then you can't make a total and you can't place in the competition. Sophia Camlin, Sweden. 225 on the bar. £500. Excuse me, I think it's a 225. It's 227.5. She essentially has done a paused squat every time.
Yeah, and I think that's really taken the toll a little bit as well. Yeah. That extra time down the bottom drains a lot of energy.
And you're bleeding power all the time you're down there because you really want a bounce out of the hole with that equipment. Christy Chivetta, Great Britain.
Yeah, she's having a great down squat so far. They've looked really good.
Looking for 230. The British equipped team crowned their first world champion in decades earlier today.
First one since 1992, I think you said.
So there is a real buzz in the British team right now. Phenomenal squat there for Christy.
Yeah, she's doing a great job, having a great day. I do like her technique, how she drives those hips forward, which is the direction that suit wants to stand up in.
Rhea Stinn, defending world champion, looking for 245. The husband, Ryan Stinn, coaching her today.
Yeah, just taking some fairly conservative jumps there. And you could see her opening squat was really tough. Second was easier, but still looked a little bit tough as well. She's putting in such a fight, and I think she's got it. She has. She stands it up.
What an incredible squat. So much determination.
They picked those numbers absolutely perfectly, didn't they? Any more than that, and it might not have happened.
I think if a fly had landed on the end of the bar, it wouldn't have happened. That was right on the limit. So that gives Rhea the bronze on squat. This is Anna Herringer, Norway, for 265 that she missed last time.
Let's see if she can put it on the board for this one.
She's guaranteed the silver medal either way.
Gets it back to the top. And it's not deep enough.
No, that's a real shame. Gives her a best squat of 260, but she does still take the silver medal on squat. We award medals for each of the disciplines.
Yeah, the Norwegian coach is taking a walk to the jury. And there's a bit of discussion. We'll see what happens. Nope, and he's being told clearly that it wasn't deep enough.
And now we have Daria Rusinenko looking to extend her own world record by 10 kilos.
That is a huge, huge jump. I mean, given by the way this 278 move, I certainly don't doubt this is well within reach.
It's certainly not impossible.
But
I think
how much energy is it using, and you've still got the rest of the competition to go?
A little bit ambitious maybe, but if they feel that's within her wheelhouse, and she wants to extend that squat world record out of anyone else's reach.
I think it'll certainly put it out of reach for a while.
She's a light 84 as well, weighed in today at 78.7.
No. Oh, just a bit too much there.
That's a shame, I think. Yeah, it's easy to be wise after the event, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it's pretty easy to sit in this spot here and make those calls.
She still takes the gold, and she has extended her world record to 278 kilos, so that's not a bad day's work. So there are the results in front of you. Daria Rusinenko on 278 for the gold. Anna Herringer with 260 for the silver. Reyestin takes the bronze with a hard-fought 245. We move straight into the men's group now. These are the super heavyweight men. They've all weighed in at above 120 kilos. And we will begin with Ionut Florin Lupash.
Yeah, look, if you want a world record in this weight class, you're going to need to squat more than half a ton.
Wow, 505.
That is huge.
Here's Lupash for 367 and a half. He's squatted for 12 and a half in the past.
Yeah, I think it's been a little while since he's squatted up in the 412s. So a smart opening number.
Yeah, you're right. He did 410 in Stavanger 21, but that was not quite to depth. Yeah,
that was
quite
shy
high.
There.
Next out, it's Christoph Seefeld, Germany, looking to open with 385.
Yeah, and no stranger to the European and world stage.
Took the bronze medal last year.
Just going to say, his bronze medalist last year totaled 1,010 kilos, which is not his biggest total.
Yeah, you're right. 10-12 and a half got him the European title earlier this year.
Spends a long time getting down, but you wouldn't know by the way he stands it up.
No, the ascent was smooth and it was fast. He's on the board. Carefully controlling his path.
Yeah, great squat.
Good to know Magnusson, Iceland, for 385. I have to give my apologies here. I tried my hardest to pronounce it properly, and that was the closest I could get.
You can see there, opening lift, he hasn't got those wraps super tight yet. He's giving himself a little bit of room to play.
Wow, he's
that
strong today.
Rocket fast. He is going to hit some big numbers today.
He's struggled in this in competition on squat a few times, so that'll give him a big boost to get his opener in. And here's a young man on his way up. This is Zen McCollum, USA. Still a junior.
Yeah, really want to see him get his opener on here.
He had a bit of a nightmare last year at his first Open Worlds.
Yeah, let's call it a bit of a nightmare. Speed was really good. He dropped into it nicely.
Yeah,
maybe a little too fast. You can see he got a little bit offline on the way back up, but he pulled it back together.
The exuberance of youth.
Oh, he slowed it down well.
Here is Ricardo Coloma, Ecuador. He's been here all week. The Ecuadorian team have had a great success this week.
Busy week for them. There's been plenty of medals.
Opening with 400 kilos. Hasn't been to an Open World Championship before. Did the juniors all the way back in 2009.
Stands it up very easily, didn't he? It is three whites.
Looks good to the referees too. And here's Joe Capolino, USA.
He was so close to that world championship last year. He just couldn't lock out that last deadlift.
I think he'll be challenging this year too. Opening with 410. Now he squatted 460 kilos back at the World Games last year.
Absolutely monstrous opening at 410, so a pretty conservative opener. We know what he's capable of.
He's got such big legs, it's hard to tell depth from the front.
Now he does a really nice job there of dipping in, which is very hard to do in this weight class and with that amount of weight. But he gets that one on the board really well. He's controlled and then just dips and pops out of the hole.
This is Carlos Campos Murillo from Costa Rica, opening with 420.
So he didn't put a total on in Vivo last year. He missed his bench. He squatted 395 last year, so this is a pretty big squat.
His nomination, his qualifying numbers that he came in with said 455. So he's clearly made a lot of progress on this lift. In equipped lifting, it's not just about strength gains, it's about learning how to make the best use of the equipment.
Well, he has no problem with strength or moving that bar.
But
he
it
does have a problem with depth, though.
It did move very well, though. He leant forward.
Yeah.
So his body was dropping, but his hips weren't. And the hips must be below the top of the knee.
And it's quite deceptive for the athlete as well, because you feel like you're getting lower.
Waiting in the wings, we have Andriy Shevchenko, Ukraine. And the Ukrainian team have been fantastic this week.
Yeah, so he was the gold medalist from Vivol last year. In the maximum 442 and a half squat.
We have an overall. Is that for Campos Murillo?
I think that is Campos Murillo. It gets
is.
A good lift.
Fantastic. So he's on the board. But this is Shevchenko for 430. Super strong. Let's wait for the ref's lights. They're keeping us in suspense.
Yeah, let's try to build the moment. Hopefully we'll get a result soon. Yeah, there
three
it is.
White lights and a good lift for Shevchenko. Game on. So here are the results, including the B group that lifted this morning. Shevchenko is leading with 430. Bollard from the B group on 422.5. Murillo 420. Here is Ian at Florin Lupash, Romania. He missed 367 and a half on his opener, and he's gone all the way up to 385.
Yeah, it's a big call. I mean, it's not unusual to add some kilos to try and push through the suit, but that's a lot of kilos on there, 385.
It really is. It's difficult when you miss your opener, though, because your game plan's in the bin, and if you want to stay in touch, you're going to have to keep going up. I don't think that was much different.
He has cut it a little bit shy there and just couldn't get the power out, and then obviously couldn't push it all the way through. So he comes down, he cuts up a little bit short.
The more energy, the potential energy you can put into that suit, the better it rewards you with a pop out of the hole. Christoph Seefeld, Germany, 405 on the bar.
And throw on an extra 20 kilos there. I've got a list of best lift for him is 385. So this would be massive.
That slow controlled descent we saw from his first squat.
That is a huge personal best.
And it didn't look too different from his opener, so we think he's got a little bit of strength in reserve there.
380 at the Europeans and 382 and a half in Vivorg, so that is huge.
Guðfinnur Magnusson, Iceland, is looking for 407.5.
So this will give him a little bit of a personal best as well.
Long way up from the 380 he did last year in Viborg. Good depth.
I think he's good on that.
Pressed forward into the knee wraps right at the bottom. He's rewarded with a great ascent.
He is really powerful today.
This is moving fast. Here comes Zen McCollum. Took the silver medal at the juniors last year.
And really great, he's got his first lift on, which means he can get to business now.
That was tons better.
Yeah, a lot steadier through there. Kept his line a lot better on that one.
Bryce Lewis in his corner today. I think he trains with Bryce. The next lifter out will be Ricardo Coloma. He's come a long way from Ecuador, but he travelled out. He's been here all week. One of the difficulties is recovering from travel, or if you had any problems from travel when you're going halfway around the world to compete.
Yeah, it can be quite challenging. I mean, a lot of these guys have gotten here quite early to give themselves plenty of time to get used to it, put back on a little bit of weight.
He was strong under the bar for 400. This is 20 kilos more.
Well, he's looking pretty strong under 420. Two whites.
2-1 is all you need.
Thank you.
Next out, we have Big Joe Cap, Joseph Capolina from the USA, 427.5.
Well, I think Big Joe is a bit of an understatement, really.
Weighed in at 163 kilos today. But these are all big guys.
Consistency is the key here for Joe. Get some numbers on the board, add to that total. Put himself in position to challenge.
He is absolutely a contender here. So nearly took it last year.
Yeah, he pulled for the win, just couldn't lock it out completely.
It was a tough one, but he got it to the top.
Yeah, I'd be interested to see what their next step is. I mean, we know Joe's got a lot more in him. Oh, not deep enough. So then his next lift selection gets really interesting here, because if he doesn't add more weight, he is really going to open the door. Oh, the jury's already overruled that.
That was a good lift.
It is a good
Joe
lift.
Capolino.
That's great for Joe.
Yeah, I was surprised when the red lights went up, but the referees only have a split second to make their decision. The jury has got it live, and there are two different views on the monitors and a replay. Here is Carlos Campos Murillo, open with 420, and this will be a Masters 1 world record at 435. Masters 1 is the age category 40 to 49. He is lifting in the open, but he can still take the Masters World Record.
And this will shatter the Masters World Record. The current Masters World Record is 425.5. This is going to destroy it.
No, it was easy, but was it deep?
It was very easy. No. Not deep enough, though.
That's a real shame, and three red lights cannot be overturned. Only a 2-2-1 decision can be overturned. But it was, yeah, significantly high.
Yeah, but going by how easy that lift was, I mean, does he now come out with the absolute confidence, well, I can sink this another couple of inches and still stand up easily, not a problem.
It would be a bold move. Very risky. Here's Andriy Shevchenko, Ukraine, with 450. Silver medalist in the 120s there, coaching him, Bichkov. And we've seen this all week, haven't we? World champions step off the podium.
Yep, off
and
the
then
podium.
Coaching, refereeing, helping the team. Now, I think this matches the best he's done in competition.
He's having a really hard time getting through that suit, wasn't he? Didn't get down deep enough. He looked really uncomfortable right throughout that spot.
Yeah, he just didn't seem to be able to. Yeah, that was fine. So that's where we are at the end of the second round of squats, with Shevchenko on 430, Capolina on 427.5, Jordan Bollard 422.5.
He's still up there.
Third round of squats. This is the round we hand out our medals. And here is Iron Up Florin Lupash. Nothing on the board and 385 on the bar.
Yeah, it's an all or nothing squat now. He's just got to sink it in and give it everything he's got. Oh, I don't know if that one was deep enough either.
I don't think so, unfortunately.
No, it wasn't.
So, unfortunately, he cannot place in the competition. He can still carry on competing, and he could take a medal in the bench or deadlift, but he cannot place in the competition. Christoph Seefeld now, Germany, for 4:15. This will be a European M1 record. You do find a lot of Masters lifters, a lot of older lifters lifting in the equipped, because it takes years of experience to really master the equipment. Beep was telling me he had 30 seconds left to set up to the satisfaction of the referees and get the start command. Yeah, that's no surprise really. He was all over the place at the bottom of the squat there.
Yeah, his previous two were a lot smoother on the way down. Even though he hangs around the bottom for a while, he was a lot smoother. This one, he was just shooting back and forth.
Yeah, his knees were back and forth. I think he lost that on the descent, really. Gudfinnur Magnusson, Iceland, 4:17 and a half.
This will beat his best lift by 10 kilos.
So if you take a look at the graphic that's on your screen at the minute, there's a lot of information on there. The bottom bar will populate with the lifts and whether they were good or bad as we progress through the competition. And that top grey bar will tell you whether this lift will move the lifter up or not. And this will move him up in squat from 7th to 6th. Big personal best on the go.
Oh, just couldn't quite get the power he needed.
And that's a big weight to get back in the bar. The lifter and the bar combined. Get back in the rack.
Yeah, the guys did a really good job on that. He got all out of sorts trying to get back up.
Next out we have Zen McCullum for 4:20, and he looks fired up and ready for it.
Yeah, well, this will be his biggest lift. This will be his biggest international lift. Might even be his biggest lift, actually.
Yeah, I think so. He did 4:15 at his nationals. Unfortunately, he folded a little bit under the weight there. Just as he was approaching the bottom of the squat, he kind of lost his back position a little bit.
Yeah, it was a bit all over the place, and that knee wrap. He's very high on his knee as well.
So that was a best squat of 4:10 for Zen McCullum. Here's Ricardo Coloma, Ecuador, 4:27 and a half. This will move him up to silver medal position with three lifters still to go.
Putting in the fight, but just couldn't quite keep it going.
That was a great effort, though.
These are such huge weights. When it slows down that much, it's very difficult to really keep the fight going.
And after a week of competition, the platform crew is like a Formula One pit crew. They're moving so quickly. Carlos Campos Murillo. He missed his M1 world record attempt of 4:35. I mean, he's so strong, but
yeah,
just not deep enough.
Yeah, moved really easy. He just needs to get down a lot further.
Next out is Anna Herringer, Norway. Missed 147 and a half. She's gone up 152 and a half. It's a bit risky, but if you're one of the challengers, if you're one of the people looking for the overall podium, you have to stay in touch.
Yeah, look, if you've come here to chase after a world champion or championship or a podium finish, you have to take the risk. And I think it's paid off.
Yeah, that looked good from here. We have that yellow card again from the side. So the jury are just reviewing the replay. They're seeing it from more than one angle, though, whereas we only get the front. And I see no movement.
Yep, I haven't seen anyone reach for the button.
So that stands for Herringer. And here is Sofia Kamlund, Sweden. 152 and a half on the bar.
She has to work so hard on that lockout. I don't think she's going to get this one.
I don't think she can lock it out. That's a real shame. It was a nice touch. She was well in control. But just didn't have quite enough pop to get it all the way to the top. Here's Anki Timmers. Seems to be the only one having a good bench day today.
Yeah. Well, I mean, this is one of her favorite lifts is the bench. She competed in World Bench as well. She hit 195 there.
This is 190. That's an enormous weight to hold over your face. And while you're at extension, the bench shirt isn't really helping you, so you're holding that yourself. It's only when you start to bring it down to the chest that the bench shirt starts to make sense.
Great press, very strong in the lockout.
There's a little bit of lateral movement. She did really well to control that.
Yeah, she looked like she touched it a bit high on her chest. Oh, she's got two reds with yellow cards.
The book came off, I'm told. So that's a real shame. And now we have Rhea Stint for her second attempt at 195. Could really do with getting this one on. It's so nerve-wracking for the lifter if they come out for their third with nothing on the board.
Yeah, it's a tough position to be in, even though, you know, in equipped lifting there's so many things we can do, and it happens quite regularly, it doesn't make you feel any better.
No. I think we've... Most equipped lifters have been in this position. Now, as long as she kept her butt on the bench.
Yeah, I think that from here it looks good, but obviously we can't see the side. Three whites.
Three white lights. She's on the board and she's in the lead. So, missing your first, it means whatever plan you came in with is now unavailable. But she's in the lead with 195. Tim is on 185. Herringer on 152 and a half. Shane Oberg for her final bench of the day, 112 and a half. And I think that's a good move, just going up the minimum amount. Her second wasn't easy at all.
Yeah, she had to put in a bit of effort on the second there, so 2.5 kilos.
But what adjustments could they have made, Gary, to go into a third lift?
Look, in a third lift with 2.5 kilos, I probably wouldn't have done a whole lot. Maybe just pull the shirt, maybe just a centimetre down. Mm-hmm. Any more than that, it's not going to get a touch. And it's worked perfectly for them.
So
that looked easier than her second, I think.
It did. Nice 3 for 3 for Oberg. And we have Kristi Chivetina. Exactly what we were just talking about. She's coming out for a third with nothing on the board. If she misses this, she cannot place in the competition.
Yeah, she's going to keep that butt on the bench.
She had such a great time on squats.
Everyone here in this crowd wants her to get this lift on. Every athlete out the back wants her to get this lift on.
We all know how this feels. And she locked it. She's locked it out.
She's got the lock. I didn't see any hip movement. Three wide. She gets it on the board.
Wow.
Just very good of her to build that suspense for us there. I really appreciate that.
That was a tense moment. But we have all our lifters still with us so far. And here's Daria Rusinenko, Ukraine.
Yeah, 147.5, just below her best lift.
Konstantin Musienko there. He narrowly missed the world title the other day. He was a silver medalist.
That was good. It was three whites.
She's wearing a belt and her shirt didn't shift about too much.
Yeah, I mean, it can be very... the problem is, too, when the shirt slides up, you lose a lot of that power from the chest plate as well.
This is Sofia Kamlund, Sweden, to take another swing at the 152.5 she missed last time. They've all been slow, but I don't think she's going to be able to lock that one out.
Yeah, it's just hanging around too long. She got a little bit more speed off the chest. She doesn't generally, you know, lifting get a lot of speed off the chest. She's got that sort of slow squeeze. And I think a little bit more speed is really helpful with the bigger weights.
Next out, we have our third place lifter. She is guaranteed the bench bronze, looking to add 5 kilos to her total with 157.5.
Having to work hard, but I did see some hip movement in that one. Let's see what the referees say. Oh, I think I saw more hip movement than I thought I saw.
I don't think she made it. I think it went over the top.
Just couldn't lock out at the end.
And when the weight starts to get behind your wrist, there's very little you can do to salvage that. Now here's Enki Timmers for 190 for the second time of asking.
Look, Enki is a seasoned professional. This won't be bothering her too much. The fact that she's got one on the board helps to ease those nerves a little bit. She'll just come out and correct what needed correcting.
She's got quite a high touch point, hasn't she? Quite high up on her chest, so probably why it's not bothering her so much that her shirt's sliding so far. Blues. So, on bench, blue card can be either for downward movement of the bar or lockout. Her elbow's kind of locked and unlocked. No, that's an overrule. That was a good lift from Timmers.
As we say with the downward movement of the bar, it has to be the whole bar. So it's okay if it ladders up like that.
Yeah.
Comes up on one side, then comes up on the other.
And our final bench in the women's session is Reyestin. No surprise there. 202.5. Now that's a bit lower than we would usually see from Rhea.
Yeah, but I think it's a really great that she's lifting for her capacity at this moment.
Travelled a long way from Canada. That looks good.
Yeah, I think that should be okay. It is three whites.
So that gives Reyestin the gold medal on bench press. And the lead in the competition, but it is close. So there we go, 202.5 for the gold medal for Reyestin, 198 for the silver for Anki Timmers, and Anna Heranga takes the bronze with 152.5. We move straight into the men's competition now. Ricardo Colomer is going to lead the way, looking for 240.
There'll be some big, big benches in this session. I don't think we'll get up to world record size today, given that it's 425.5.
That is a ridiculous amount.
It's a number you expect
to
see for a squat record. Yeah.
It would be impressive for a squat record. But this is Ricardo Coloma, Ecuador, 240 on the bar. Oh, wow.
Oh, rockets off.
Super easy. Carlos Campos Murillo, Costa Rica, for 295. Didn't have the best time on squats. He was so strong under the bar, but just struggled technically. Current best is 325.
A lot of compression out of that shirt and a lot of speed as well.
That was a great opening bench.
Just see how much that shirt compressed across his chest there.
Next out, Gudfinnur Magnusson, Iceland. We're already up to 300 kilos, and these are just the openers. Gets harder and harder for the platform crew to hand these weights out.
Yeah, I'm just looking at that. Really feeling for the guy in the center spot of position having to lift all these out.
So with the raw bench, you can give a lot of assistance in the handout as the lifter. But in equipped, you're really compromised by the shirt. And that was a nice bench. Next out, Ionut Lupaș, Romania, 305.
Yeah, and look, unfortunately, he didn't get a squat on the board. But he's out here putting on his best bench. He can still contend for medals in individual lifts, but he just can't total or contend for overall medals.
Yeah, it looks really good. He tucks in really hard, brings his elbows in, gets a low touch point, and it shoots to lock out.
305 and 8.5 is then McCollum, USA. Sifa, Capolino, Shotenko, get ready, bodies loaded. McCollum, USA.
Here's Zen McCollum. 305 on the bar. Now, I think this is more than we've seen him do in international competition.
Yeah, I believe so. And his squats look good, which is great. He just needs to put this one on the board.
Now, he benched 300 at his equipped nationals. So this is a PB.
Oh, struggling to get the touch, though.
That was scrappy.
That was a very scrappy looking lift, wasn't it? He gets two white lights. But it was certainly scrappy.
You can see how difficult he's finding getting the touch there. And the tighter the shirt, the more it is going to try and stop you getting the bar all the way to your chest. This is Christoph Seefeld, 317 and a half.
And the jury has overruled the previous lift, as I expected they might.
So that is no lift for Zen McCollum. Just 317 and a half for the German lifter Seefeld. And here's Joe Capolino, USA, opening with 325.
Yeah, really needs to get this opener on if he wants to stay in contention. If he doesn't get this opener on, it's going to cost him.
He benched 325 in Viborg last year, but he did put up 350 at Stavanger the year before.
Yeah, he's certainly capable of a lot more. Just a case of being able to put it all together.
It looked like the bar was touching.
Yeah, I can see the coach walking to the jury table. It was a very long press call.
But I've seen him. It did look to be touching. I watched him bench at the World Games last year, and I was in the audience looking up. And when you watch it back on the video, it looks like it's touching. But I could see daylight with my upward sort of angle.
And obviously, we don't have that angle here.
The jury's... I don't think they've ever turned. Are they going to give him another lift at the end of this round? But this is Andrei Shevchenko of Ukraine.
Rockets off the chest.
330 kilos moving.
Oh, he gets two reds with a blue and a yellow.
So, a blue... It's downward movement on lockout. The yellow could be a range of things. But that is...
Left arm did come back down again. Difficult to see on that one, but...
At any rate, that was no lift for Shevchenko. And Joe Capolino is going to get another attempt, but obviously we can't ask him to come straight out. He's literally just been on the platform.
That would be a bit tough, I think. Yeah. So we give him a couple of minutes. And now he can come out any time during this period, I believe, if he wants to.
Yeah, I think so.
He does have that extra rest time to ensure he recovers. Otherwise, you can imagine trying to lift 325 kilos, go out, wipe your hands off, and come straight back out for another roll. Would be extremely challenging to do. And that is one of the reasons we have a jury like this in these competitions. So when those things happen, the referee can only call what he sees.
Okay, so he is not coming out during this 2 minutes. He gets the 2 minutes compensatory time because he's literally just been on the platform.
He is able to come out.
No, we load the bar I've just heard the MC say that we load the bar after. Oh, the bar is already loaded, but we're running 2 minutes and then he gets his minutes afterwards.
And usually I would be using every bit of that I could.
Yeah, it's a tough situation, but if something's gone wrong with a lift, you can't turn back time. You have to do the best you can for the lifter
and
give them another attempt.
You know, I mean, the referees can only call on what they can see from where they're sitting in the angle they're seeing. And that's why we have juries, and that's why we have replays for the juries to make those decisions.
So now the bar is loaded for Joseph Capolino to retake his opening bench of 325 kilos.
And I can see him chalking his hands. He's coming out.
He just needs to make sure everything's ready before he gets past the technical controller. The only item of equipment you can adjust on the platform is your belt.
Yeah, great attitude from Joe there too. Walks out, gives the spotter the thumbs up. He's not upset by what happened. It's just part of sport. Let it get a wriggle on though.
He has the start command. Really difficult to get down, but he's got it all the way. And unfortunately,
he's put the rack, but he's still pushing.
I think there's a lot of leg drive there.
He's got two white.
He got it. He's on the board.
And I do see the red with the blue card there, and I don't think there was any full bar downward movement.
I think that was for lockout. So he did clip the rack on the way out, which made him waver about a little bit, but it's not a fail of itself. So the bench results as we have them is Joe Capolino on 325, Seafelt on 317.5, and Lupash on 305. And straight into round two with Ricardo Coloma, 255 on the bar.
Now, does this relift from Joe Capolino, how do you think that's going to affect his energy levels? Because essentially he's going to take four benches.
It's true, but he didn't press the other one out. He just held it on the chest. I know you bleed power when you're down there. It does drain the energy reserves, but not as much as if he tried to press it. And that was a good
that
bench.
That was fantastic.
Yeah.
That was as good as his first one.
Next out is Zen McCullum. He had a lot of trouble getting that bar down to his chest, so he's added 2.5 kilos, which I think is more psychological than physical.
Yeah, look, the jury overturned his lift. He never actually touched the bar properly anyway, but the shadow made it look very much like he had. Oh, and still again, just getting all out of shape.
So that's a shame for Zen, but he gets another attempt. And as we saw in the women's group, you can come back. If you'd missed two of your classic benches, you wouldn't really be expecting to get one in, would you?
Wouldn't think there'd be a chance, but in equipped every...
Yeah.
You know, I think Zen really just looked like he rushed everything on that one.
Here is Ian at Lupash, Romania, for 312.5. Down there reasonably quickly.
Yeah, I'm not really entirely sure how he managed to get such a good press out of that, because he really seemed to rush the touch.
Now he did get a yellow card from the side, and I can see the jury watching the replay, but they're
okay
relaxed
with this one.
Gudvino Magnusson, Iceland, for 312.5.
These are enormous weights for these guys to be lifting out to them. Oh, he just got a little bit out of shape there.
He could do with just telling the spotters to take that, because once it's swung around like that and you've already failed, there's no point using up the energy.
Yeah, I mean, it's a long competition. You've got to get through all your bench, then you've got to get through all your deadlift. If you are not going to make the lift, there's no point in wasting all that energy.
Carlos Campos Murillo, 315. That's a 20 kilo increase from his opener.
Yeah, not completely unusual in these bigger weight classes. A few of these guys really train for these big jumps as well. And quite often they're pulling their shirt, they're jacking their shirt quite a long way down between lifts, and that 20 kilos is needed to get the touch.
It's a good point, Gary. Equipped bench, you're not able to open light, because if the weight isn't sufficient, you won't get that bar to your chest. And that's a tough lockout.
Just can't quite lock it. Yeah, certainly. I mean, in classic bench, when someone opens their open, they don't get their open. It's often because they've opened too heavy. You don't get that option in equipped of saying, you know, oh, I'm going to open light, get an easy one on there. There is no such thing as a light open, easy open on the equipped bench.
And that's what makes it exciting.
Absolutely, one of the most exciting parts of the sport.
Yeah, for me, it's the most strategic and an exciting element of all powerlifting. But here's Christoph Seefeld, looking for 330 to move into the lead on bench, with two lifters still to make their second attempts. Nice.
Three white lights.
Here's Joe Capolino, already out for the third time on bench press for his second attempt. 332.5. This will move him into the lead with Shevchenko still to lift.
Yeah, and he's taken a fairly conservative jump. I mean, this is quite a conservative jump for Joe. And I wonder if he's doing that to try and conserve a little bit of energy.
Time on the chest again. Has he locked his right arm?
I don't think he has.
Bit of a mixed result there. So he's got one yellow card and one blue card.
Yeah, I think his head lifted off the bench as well. Obviously, we're not going to see in that replay.
It's a really difficult call, that. I couldn't really say whether his elbows were locked or not there. Here's Shevchenko, looking for 335. He's gone up five from his opener.
Yeah, look, I think what he's doing here, I think they're just trying to get a bit more speed out of the shirt. I mean, the reason he couldn't get quite to lockout was he just ran out of speed. And he got so much more speed that time.
That was super fast.
Oh, he's got two yellows again. I think that's butt lift again.
Could we see the reigning world champion leave the competition during bench press?
Well, he's certainly in a bit of trouble now. It's not the position you want to be in.
Not at all. So Seefeld is leading with 330 from Joe Capolino on 325, Lupash 312.5. Third round of bench now, and here is Ricardo Coloma, Ecuador, He's gone up another 10 to 265.
You know, it's interesting, Lupas is sitting in the bronze medal position on bench at the moment. He didn't come in here with the biggest bench nominated, but he's been consistent. That looks okay. One yellow.
One yellow, so we'll keep our eye on the jury, because they have their butt cam to check on whether it came off the bench. Jury's still discussing, but meanwhile we have Zen McCollum looking to stay in the competition with 307.5.
Well, look, we know Zen likes to create some anticipation and some atmosphere and excitement. So
he did have a nightmare on bench last year, and he got it in on his third.
He just can't get the touch.
That's a real shame.
And, you know, that is equipped lifting. Sometimes you just can't get that shirt to work the way you want it to work.
You can see how it's resisting. It's like pushing two, the same pole of two magnets together. Yeah. You try and push them together and they will just spin off. Real shame for the young lifter. But here's a good Finnur Magnusson. Missed 312.5 for his second. This is 315 to get on the provisional bench podium.
Yeah, I wasn't convinced on his way down with that one. It was clean on the way down, but he never looked like he was going to get a lot out of it.
Next out, Carlos Campos Murillo. Repeating the 315 that he missed last time, and this will get him the bench bronze temporarily at least, with four lifters still to go.
Well, the way bench is going at the moment, if you get a lift on, you've got a good shot of getting a medal in bench. Oh, I think he's come down too low on that, but he's managed it really well.
Oh, his right arm just went a bit astray.
Just can't get to lock out.
He is not having the day he wanted. He is 2-for-6 right now, but still projected in third place.
Yeah, look, he certainly didn't come in with the biggest bench nominated, but he's consistent and he's getting them on cleanly.
This is Ayanut Lupash, 320 on the bar. Took him a while to get the press command because the bar was skipping about on his chest.
But he's got that back to the top and locked it even after that amount of time down the bottom. That is impressive.
Now we'll just keep our eye on the jury because he got a yellow card fairly from a side referee. So did he lift his hips? No, not seeing any movement from the jury. That's fine.
So he is currently in the bronze medal position with three lifters to go.
Now here's Joe Capolino, USA, coming out for the 332.5 that he missed last time. This will move him into bench gold. Look at the compression across the chest there. Can he lock it out?
Oh, I don't think he can. White. No, he hasn't. And that is going to cost him a few kilos at the end.
It is. However, we have Shevchenko, who was the favorite in this class as the incoming world champion, in real trouble here.
Yeah, he's in an awkward position here because he just can't seem to put it together.
If he misses this bench, that really opens the door of opportunity for Joe Capolino. There was quite a lot of leg drive going on there.
Wait for the referees on this one and see what they say. Yeah, he's got two reds with yellow cards. And I don't think he's going to have any luck going to the jury. Because he is all over the place on that bench, isn't he?
Well, that was not what we expected to see today. The favourite in the competition is out. Could this be Big Joe Caps? Big day?
Well, it creates an opportunity for him, doesn't it? I mean, it came down to the last deadlift last year.
This is Christoph Seefeld. He is already guaranteed the bench gold.
He sure is. And Lufresh will take the bronze on that one.
And of course, with Shevchenko out now, this moves everyone else up. And Seefeld could make the podium.
I think he's got that on. No, he's got two yellow cards there.
Okay, so if we take a quick look at the bench results, Seefeld takes the gold with 330. Joe Capolino takes the silver with 325. Lupash the bronze with 320. We're going to take a short break now. Join us back here for deadlift.
To warm up in 20 minutes, and it was very emotional after the third squat, so I need some seconds to calm down and to focus on bench, but I don't have this time, so I need to hurry up a lot, and that affects the bench a lot. Yeah, so that's the problem. My performance wasn't the best, so I would like to see her winning, because she really deserves it. When she pulls 261.5, then she really deserves it. My father told me that I will be competing in deadlift competition, and I never did a deadlift. So I had a 4 weeks preparation, and then I wanted more and more and more. And even if I'm a world champion, there will always be a lifter who's stronger than me. So maybe the lifter are just stronger by relative points or have a higher body weight. But I try don't set to limit my limit at the world record and aiming for more.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back. This is Deadlift.
The deadlift is the last movement of the powerlifting competition. On that movement, the lifter's whole body is used and put to the test. The athlete approaches the bar once the central referee calls bar loaded. He then has 1 minute
to start the lift.
In the conventional or sumo position, the athlete has to pull the barbell until his shoulders, hips, and knees are fully locked. Once that position is assumed by the lifter, the central referee will give the down command. The bar has to be lowered to the ground without the lifter being allowed to drop it until it touches the floor, which completes the lift. At the end of deadlift, the powerlifting total is made, which determines the winner and final placings. There are 4 main mistakes to avoid. First, not locking your shoulders, hips, or knees at the end of the movement. Second, not completing the lift with a single upward bar movement. Third, completing the lift, hitching at the legs in order to allow you to do so. Fourth, dropping the bar after the central referee down command.
We are back, and there's all to play for in the 84 kilo women's class. We can see Raya Stin there is in the lead on 447 and a half. Daria Rusinenko on 425.5, and this is where that handy chip, that 0.5, comes in really useful. Anna Haranga on 412 and a half.
Yeah, and Timbers isn't far behind there on 410. It's going to be very, very close at the end of this.
And this makes it difficult for Haranga because she wants to move up, obviously, but she can't just directly challenge without worrying about defending from Anki Timbers behind.
We'll see how all this spreads out as they get their first deadlift on the board. This session moves really fast as well. There's not a lot of rest. There's only 7 lifters in this flight, and deadlift moves very, very quickly. So this is where energy conservation becomes very important. Not trying to go out too hard. You need to get that first lift on, solidify that total, then look at the numbers and see what do I need to do to move up to where I want to be.
We are about to get underway, and Rusinenko has a bigger deadlift than Stin, but I don't know if it's going to be big enough. But we've seen people stumble a little bit on bench today, so you never quite know what's going to happen.
Sure. We saw a lot of people stumble on bench about 10 minutes ago.
Christy Civetta is going to lead us out with 180 kilos. Yep. She gave us a fright on bench, didn't she?
Just left it to the last one.
But this is not uncommon. And she looks like she's settled herself. That's Aaron Singh. Anyone who's watched a quick lifting for long enough will have seen Aaron Singh before. He was head British coach for a lot of years. Nice opening pull there for Christy Civetta.
Yeah, great way to get started. Locks that total away now, and now she can get to work and see if she can move up in the rankings at all.
Sophia Camlund is next, looking for 182 and a half. She's lifting, deadlifting entirely raw. She's not wearing a deadlift suit. That's just a normal singlet.
Yeah, we see that quite often, though. I mean, as we've talked about throughout the week, a deadlift suit first gives us the least amount of help in a lift, the least amount of adjustment you can make. and it's the hardest and takes the longest to actually work out. I mean, you can put a deadlift suit on for the first time and go down in lift.
Now here is Rhea Stinn. She's looking for her fourth world title in a row, but she is under some pressure from Daria Rusinenko. So let's see how this 190 opener moves. We've seen her do 215 in the past.
Well, that moved really well.
So that's the important one. She's on the board. She has a total. And here's Daria Rusinenko. Now, there's another thing on Rusinenko's mind. She has to put up a successful deadlift in order to claim that squat world record. And that looks good to me.
Yeah, that looks really good. Looks like she's put someone in the tank there. She's able to put out a little bit more if she needs to later, and hopefully maybe she can put the challenge up.
Well, maybe so. We've seen her do 217 and a half in the past, and that did look super easy. Anki Timmers is out next, already on the platform for 200. We'll wait until everyone's done their first deadlift before we look at the overall rankings.
Tonight, just not giving much away with their facial expressions on deadlift. I mean, usually you can sort of pick if they're a bit tired on their opener, but they are not giving anything away tonight.
Now, here is Anna Herringer. She is a big deadlifter, opening with 212 and a half. She's done 230 in the past. Now, here's Jane Aalborg with a massive 222.5 kilo opener.
Yeah, you want to talk about big deadlifters, Jane Aalborg. This is almost 20 kilos less than her best as well.
She managed 227.5 at Viborg last year. 240 was from Dubai 2019. That didn't give her much trouble, did it?
No, it looks good.
So at the end of that round, Aalborg is leading on deadlift with 222.5, Herringer with 212.5, Rusinenko on 200. More importantly, Rhea Stinn is on 637.5, Rusinenko on 625.5, which puts her ahead of Herringer on 625.
There's just nothing in it.
This is Sofia Kamlund, Sweden, for her second deadlift, 190 on the bar.
Three whites, puts another one on the board.
Christy Civetta is out next for 190. had a good day on squats, had a bit of a stumble on bench.
Yeah, look, and the bench was just technical stuff. Wasn't that she couldn't make the presses. It was just technical errors.
Next out we have Rhea Stinn. She is in the lead. She is 12 and a half kilos ahead of Rusinenko, but Rusinenko's taking a bigger jump.
Yeah, she really needs to get these lifts on. I think if she misses any lift here, Rusinenko will sniff victory.
And Stinn will have to go first as she in the third round as she has the smaller deadlift. But she just needs to get everything she can. So she's doing her job. She is stacking kilos onto her total.
Yeah, she can't do much more than that. Doesn't get the advantage of lifting last, so she just has to do everything she can.
And here is Daria Rusinenko for 212 and a half.
Now, second lift, deadlift now, this is where we can really tell how much people are firing, how much they've got left in the tank. This will be a real giveaway, this one.
Now, we have her best down as 217 and a half. So let's hope this isn't too close to a top end. Tough lockout, but she's got it there.
It was a tough lockout. I don't think there's a huge amount of room to move. I'm sure Stinn would have been watching that to get a bit of an idea of how much they think she's got left.
That puts Rusinenko on 638 to Stinn's 645, so there really isn't much in it. Well, here's Anke Timmers for 215. This will move her up past Haranga, with Haranga still to deadlift. That's a good deadlift for Anke Timmers. She's getting close to top, though. That was Wim Wamsteker coaching her, I think.
Yeah, she got a little bit technically wrong there. But I think you're right. I think she's getting very close to the top end.
Here is Anna Sully Herringer, Norway. Gone up 10 kilos to 225, 222.5. She can't lock it.
Oh, did she overestimate that one? Feeling better than not recognizing the fatigue, maybe.
It's possible she made a small technical error. The bar rolled out a little bit.
Yeah.
So possibly she can come back and grab that.
I think she'll fix that.
Any sort of movement away from the body makes it really hard, as you've got to overcome the moment arm to bring it back in, which is using extra energy that you really need just to be taking it upwards. Jane Aarbøk now, Denmark. This is a Masters 1, so it's the 40 to 49 year age class. World record, 235. And that was smooth as anything.
It certainly was. And I thought it was her record that she was beating there.
Is it hers?
It is her own record. Just extended a little bit further.
So those are the standings right now, with Rhea Stinn on 645, Rusinenko chasing on 638. Timmers and Haranga on 625. This is close. There are four lifters here who are looking for the podium.
Yeah, and Timmons has her on body weight as well. And Lithuania is still within striking distance.
Yeah, and she's put 220 on for her third, and that gives her, that will mean she's half a kilo over what Stin's on now. Excuse me, Sophie Camland on 195, just a little bit too heavy. But that's a really great example where that chip, that half kilo chip, means that Rustenenko doesn't have to do a full 2.5 to go past Stin. Kristi Chiveta for her final lift of the day, 200 kilos on the bar.
The magic 200. It's one of those powerlifting milestones, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't think she's hit this on the platform before. Would be great to see her do it.
Oh, just not quite there today.
It's hard to do your best work when you're so fatigued from all the work you've done before. Here's Reya Stin. Can she put it out of reach for the young Ukrainian?
Yeah, look, I think if she puts this one on, I think she really does put it out of reach, going by Lysenko's last lift.
Yeah, I think so too. She's going to want to get this on the board. And that's why she's the three-time back-to-back world champion. Very nearly got a smile out of Ryan Stin there. Very nearly. Okay, we have an attempt change. Usually when you put your attempts in, you cannot change them. However, on third deadlift, you're allowed two changes, which gives you a little bit of chance to do some strategic gameplay.
Yeah, Rusinenko's dropping her lift to 215.
She has conceded the victory, and she is going to defend against Anki Timmers, who's moved ahead of Herringer. So I think that's a smart move. She wasn't going to catch Stin, but she doesn't want to give up her silver, so this is 215.
Yeah, and I think that was a really good decision. I don't think 220 was there.
And
well, she would have actually needed 220.
2.5, I think.
Yeah.
But a silver medal behind Reya Stin is no shame.
3-time world champion. That's impressive.
4 now, I think.
4 now.
Yeah, she went into
Stavanger.
Here's Anna Herringer. She is attempting to get on the overall podium as well as the deadlift podium. 222.5. And she's locked it out, but I think the bar dipped.
Yeah, I'm not entirely sure there.
Yeah,
unfortunately. She gave it everything she had, though. So, as expected, an attempt change going in.
So, Anki Timmers had a placeholder there at 230. She's come down to 225. She is assured now of the overall bronze, so she's looking at deadlift medals. This will move her up to silver. Thank you.
a bit too much today, but she does take home the bronze medal, though.
That's a decent day's work. Now, what's this? Jane Olberg is going to attempt. Whose record is this? This is Agata Shitko.
Yeah, I think it is.
This is the
this is huge.
Deadlift world record that Agata Shitko did in Pilsen last year. 252 kilos. But Gary, this is a big jump from her second. How do you think that will affect?
Look, it really is. Look, I think if anyone can do it, she can. And I think, you know what, how often do you get the opportunity to have a crack at a world record?
That's very true. You can only break a world record at an international competition.
That's right. So she's using this opportunity.
There she goes. She is fired up and ready.
She already has deadlift gold. She's got nothing to lose and everything to gain. And let's not forget, she's also a Masters 1 lifter.
It was worth a try.
I would have loaded it up as well.
Absolutely.
It could be the only opportunity you ever get to take a crack at it.
She took the Masters 1, well, she extended her own Masters 1 world record anyway. Finishes in fifth place.
She did get it moving.
She did get it moving. So here are the results for us. Rhea Steen is our four-time world champion with 650. Rusinenko takes the silver with 640.5. Anki Timmers on body weight at 625. And without time to catch her breath from all that excitement, we are straight into the men's competition with Ionut Lupash, 270 for his opening pull.
Well, there was a bit of carnage on the bench press, and everything has changed now. Shevchenko is out of the race now.
I took a look down his lifting record, and he has never bombed out of an international competition before. But of course, we don't know what conditions he's facing at home in Ukraine. This is Lupash, 270.
Smoke the opener.
Really quick. Here's Zen McCollum. Unfortunately, had even more of a nightmare on bench this year than last. Didn't manage to get one in. Opening his deadlift at 295. Looked decent.
Yeah, gets that one on the board. But I think with his bench, he just really needs to be a bit more patient on getting that touch. He's young. He's got many, many years ahead of him in this sport.
Woodfino Magnusson, Goofy to his friends, is opening his deadlift with 295.
Well, he's a big lad. I'd really want to make sure he's my friend before I start calling him Goofy. Great start there.
Next out, here's Ricardo Coloma, Ecuador. Opening with 300 kilos.
His lockout was a little slow at the top there, but we haven't seen him lift in a long, long time in international, so perhaps he just locks out like that.
Next lifter out will be Christoph Seefeld, Germany, 3:10. He took the gold medal on bench. And with Shevchenko out of the running now, everyone is eyeing those podium places.
Yeah, everyone's everything has changed now. The current world record 405.5 is set in Dubai in 2019.
Here's Joe Capolino. He is the front runner at this point.
This becomes the very important lift, doesn't it? Suddenly your open is so much more important now.
That's a great lift.
Yeah, that was a great open. It moved really well. He locked it out cleanly.
He has taken the silver medal or the bronze medal so many times. Could this be the day Big Joe Cap finally takes the gold?
You know, and I'm really happy to see such a clean lockout. That's what let him down last year in Viborg. He couldn't lock the knees properly at the end of that deadlift.
So here is Andrei Shevchenko. Of course, he didn't get a bench, but he still continues in the competition. Could take a deadlift medal. Keeps his squat gold. Good lift for Shevchenko. Carlos Campos Muilo, he's not had a great day. He's only got his openers in, or he's at least got one lift in each discipline.
Hasn't been the best day, but he is certainly in contention.
He's definitely in touch. He's looking good for a podium finish, actually. This is 3:37 and a half. Has a PB of 3:70.
I guess if you're in contention for a podium, it makes a bad day a good day, doesn't it?
Well, if you're making a podium with the 2 for 6 or 3 for 6, then wouldn't like to see what you could do if you got all nine in. And we'll take a quick look at the deadlift standings. So Taras Gechas from the B group is leading with 3:60 ahead of Campos Murillo on 3:37.5, Zmushka 3:32.5. Zmushka from the B group as well.
So after round one, we currently have two from the B group.
Yep.
Up in the middles. Obviously, we've quite a few lifts to come yet.
So this is Ayanut Lupaș, Romania, 2:95 on the bar.
I feel like he's getting to the top of his limit there. I think there's more there, but I don't think there's a whole heap more there. And his left hand started to give way at the end of that.
Just taking a quick look at the overall standings. Joe Capolino is 10 kilos ahead of Campos Murillo, who is only 7.5 ahead of Seefeld. And then the rest of the field is a little way back from that, but there is nothing in it for the top three at all.
Yeah, I still don't think Capolino's far enough out in front yet. He's still within reach.
Here's Ricardo Coloma, Ecuador. Added 10 to his opener. This is 3:10. And he just hit a wall there.
Yeah. I think he's just got to that point where fatigue has taken over. On any other day of the week, there'd probably be no problem at all.
Zen McCullum taking a decent jump up to 312.5. He's pulled 322.5 before. But not necessarily having his best day today.
Looks good. Not an easy thing to do, to brush yourself off after missing all your benches and get back out there to put on your best performance.
Gudfinnur Magnusson, Iceland, is out next for 312.5. Sitting in fourth place, he is only just ahead of Jordan Bollard, who lifted in the B group. But I think that lift will push him out ahead of Jordan.
I think Jordan Bollard from the B group could finish probably fifth overall. Or thereabouts.
But look at this, Christoph Seefeld is coming out for 3:30. This will put him in the lead with the other two front runners still to come. But if you get ahead and they miss, so this will be a European M1 total record.
It's a big call. You had a world championship, it's the time to do it.
It's the first step, get ahead of the rest. See if they can catch you.
Oh, he just lost balance at the top there. He was struggling a little bit with lockout, but I just think he got a little bit off balance.
He gets another attempt at that.
It came off the floor really well. Yeah, just a little bit off balance at the top.
An important lift now for Joe Capolino.
Yeah, he's being threatened there. They're trying the challenge.
He is well within his personal best. This is 3:30, and he needs to hit this cleanly.
He does just that.
His deadlifts are looking so much better this year.
Yeah, he's really cleaned it up. I would imagine after Viborg, he's gone back, he's watched the videos, and he's worked on that so much. He's not going to go down that road again. Look at him lock those knees out now. He's really making it clean.
Here's Shevchenko for 3:50. He's in with the shout of the deadlift medals. And it must be heartbreaking for him. He's never bombed out to international competition before. He's lost his world title.
Yeah, that first one is always the toughest to deal with.
Here comes Carlos Campos Murillo from Costa Rica. 3:52.5, it won't move him past Joe Capolino.
No, but he does need to put this one on, otherwise he is at risk of being knocked off that silver medal.
That looked good. He thought it was good, and the referees do too.
He was convinced. I wasn't going to argue with him.
So let's take a look at what that does to the scoreboard. Joe Capolino leads on 10.82.5. Carlos Campos Murillo a distance behind on 10.67.5. Seafeld on 10.45. So it's going to take a lot to catch Joe Capolino now.
I honestly think Capolino's far enough out in front now. I don't think Campos has got quite enough to go after him.
This is Lupaș, Romania. 3.10 on the bar. Unfortunately didn't make a squat, so he won't be making a total.
But he is making a statement.
He got a red card failure from the side referee. In deadlift, the red card is for lockout, so either knees not locked or shoulders not back. Maybe from that angle, the right knee did look soft, but it didn't from where we were looking. This is why we have three referees spaced around the platform.
Of course, we're in the third round now, so the bar gets cleaned after every lift to ensure every lifter has the same opportunities.
Now here's Ricardo Colomo. He didn't make 3.10, so he's gone up to 3.17.5.
You know, if this was a squat, I'd be going, yeah, great idea. Not such a great idea in deadlift. I mean, it does move up the total ranks to fifth. I think, yeah, it was a big call.
It was, but he had nothing to lose there. The seventh place man cannot come past him. Ah, but he can't move up. He's trying to come past Jordan Bollard.
Yeah, so I think it looks like Bollard will finish fifth overall.
Gudfinnur Magnusson now, Iceland. 3.20. He's sitting in fourth place. He can't catch the top three.
Giving it everything he's got. Can he lock it out?
That's a little bit soft for me.
Yeah, I don't know if he was locked. You got two whites.
The referees think he was, and that's all that matters. Next out, we have Zen McCollum. Bryce Lewis in his corner there, looking for 3.25, which I think would be a personal best for him.
Yeah, and any of these guys that are coming out after not getting in a squat or not getting in a bench deserve the biggest round of applause, because it is the hardest thing to do, because honestly, all you feel like doing is packing your kit and going home.
Yeah, absolutely. But international platform experience is invaluable.
He got there in the end. It was an awkward lockout, though. But he gets it there.
And he gets a deadly PB.
Great character. A great young man.
So we have Christoph Seefeld, Germany. He missed 3.30, he's gone up to 3.32.5, and to try to knock Campos Murillo off the second place.
A little bit, he's 20 kilos lighter than Campos.
And this will give him a European M1 total record.
Yes, a big, big weight. He didn't get the 3.30. Got off balance at the top of the 3.30, but he was struggling with the lockout before he got off balance. Can he dig deep enough? Is a sniff of a silver medal enough? Well, he's got
it
there.
He has.
He has two whites.
He was called on hitching with the blue card. I can see the jury all watching the replay. Not sure. No movement. That's great. So Seafelt has moved past Campos Murillo. So I think, well, anything can happen. We've seen
David Quinn report
a huge amount on his last deadlift to win. So I'm not going to crown Joe Cap world champion until the lifts are in.
I would think he's far enough ahead, but you know what? We've seen amazing things happen when someone gets a sniff of a gold medal.
That is a fine way to finish your competition.
Does he get the three whites? He does. He's done everything he can do. All he can do now is wait. He just has to wait.
Two lifts remain. I'm expecting Campos Murillo to put a change in.
Yeah, he'd have to go to, 372 and a half.
Yep, I think he will. First, we have Shevchenko for 355. So Campos Murillo is going to have to decide whether he's trying to challenge for silver or gold. Well, that seems to be leaving the floor before he'd even finished his setup. He's so strong.
Yeah, look, I mean, look at the size of it. He just looked at it and the bar started to lift off the floor. Is he putting a change in? He hasn't.
No, I think he's going for this total record. But another 5 kilos on it would challenge for... No, it'd have to be another 7.5, wouldn't it?
Yeah, you'd have to go 7.5 to challenge for the...
No, attempt change is going in.
Now. Is he going to load it up? No, he's dropped it down.
He wants silver medal. He thinks the gold's out of range, and I think that's smart.
I think it is. I think it might have been a stretch to try and go after that gold. So, Capolino takes the gold.
Joe Capolino is your new 2023 equipped world champion.
Finally gets his world champion. He has been so close so many times.
The bridesmaid so many times. He finally gets to take the top step of the podium.
And this lift here is for the silver medal.
355 on the bar. Final lift of the day to take the silver medal from Christoph Seafelt.
Oh, I'm not 100% sure on this
one. I'm going to wait for the referee's decision.
Oh, it's too wide.
2-1. A good lift. He moves up to the silver medal position, but I can see the jury are reviewing the lift. Did he hitch it? That little movement there, was that a hitch?
That's a tough one.
I'm waiting for the jury to decide. Nope, no overturn. These are our results in deadlift. Tadas Gechas from the B group takes the gold with 360. Campos Murillo the silver with 355 on body weight ahead of Shevchenko. But the big news is Joe Capolino is world champion with 1087.5 ahead of Campos Murillo with 1070. Seafelt takes the bronze, 1067.5. What an incredible session that was. after an absolutely phenomenal session, we have the medal ceremony coming up. We're just waiting for all the athletes to get into their tracksuit, and then they will be brought out onto the platform. It takes a while to get your deadlift suit off and to get your tracksuit on and make yourself look presentable, but here they come. This was the 84 kilo class. We had a world record from Daria Rusinenko on the squat. We saw some of these ladies have a bit of a struggle on bench and only just get theirs in. So first up, we will award the squat medals. The bronze goes to Rhea Stinn, who squatted 245. The silver to Anna Heringer for 260. And with a huge world record, the gold in squat goes to Daria Rusinenko.
Well, ladies, thank you. And now to bench press. Sorry to rush you. Thank you, ladies.
Next, we will award the medals for bench. The bronze goes to Anna Heringer with 152.5. Anki Timmers takes the silver with 190.
And, of course, bench press gold.
And no surprise that the bench press gold goes to Canada's Rhea Stinn. 202.5. It's a bit less than we usually see for her. But winning beats records any day.
And now to deadlift in bronze medal position with 215 kilos of deadlift.
The final lift medals, it's deadlift. Anki Timmers takes the bronze with 215. Daria Rusinenko takes the silver with 215.
A deadlift gold with 235 kilos.
Jane Aarberg, the gold with 235. She also extended her own Masters 1 world record. Had a crack at the Open world record. She got it moving, but it didn't go far. But it was worth a try. Lastly, and most importantly, these are the overall medals. Anki Timmers, the bronze, with a 625 kilo total. Daria Rusinenko, the silver, with 640.5. She really pushed Rhea Stinn very hard indeed. Still a junior, she has years to improve. But for the fourth time in a row, Rhea Stinn of Canada, 650 total for the gold medal and the world title. What a brilliant result for Reyestin. She really seems to be on a roll at the moment. Four world titles in a row, and she took the super heavyweight gold medal from the World Games last year. But absolutely brilliant lifting from all these ladies. Just collecting their participation medals as they leave the platform. Just making it to the World Championships is a real achievement. You have to battle your way through your national championships, come out on top to be selected to come here. So that's a great reminder of a phenomenal achievement. Next, we have the men's medal ceremony. And the 120 plus class was split into an A and a B group. The B group lifted earlier today, so there are some faces you won't have seen in this session. And we have some medals from the B group too, quite a few medals from the B group. We are going to start with the squat medals. And the bronze medal goes to Jordan Bollard from the B group, 422.5. Hasn't been lifting for a huge amount of time, lifting equipped. So that's an amazing achievement to be on that podium with names like Joe Capolino and Andriy Shevchenko. Here is Joe Capolino taking his silver medal for his 427.5 kilo squat. And Shevchenko, although he didn't make a successful bench and couldn't place in the competition, still gets his gold for his 430 squat. Next up, we'll award the medals for bench with Ionut Florin Lupash from Romania taking the bronze with 320. Joe Capolino had some difficulty with his first bench, got a retake, ended up with the silver medal at 325. Germany's Christoph Seefeld taking the gold in bench there with a massive 330 kilos. We have the deadlift medals now, and Carlos Campos Murillo from Costa Rica takes the bronze medal with 352.5. Really challenged Joe Capolino there. Andriy Shevchenko takes the deadlift silver with 355. Just getting a handshake from the IPF president there, Gaston Parage. And from the B group, 360 kilos for Tadas Gečas, Lithuania. Home nation hero. Here are the overall placings. Carlos Campos Murillo from Costa Rica with 1067.5. Just losing out on body weight to Germany's Christoph Seefeld. 1067 for the silver. When two lifters get the same weight, the lighter body weight takes the advantage. But here is the super heavyweight champion of the world, Joe Capolino, USA. Finally, he's up there. 1087.5 kilo total. Brilliant.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be outstanding for the national anthem of the United States of America.
as the lifters return to the back of the stage, and they will, from and out around the platform, just give their final wave to the camera as they receive their participation medals and leave the platform. That brings a fantastic World Open Equipped Powerlifting Championships in Druskininkai, Lithuania, to a close after a brilliant week of lifting.